Live It Like Lisa here, and in today's video I thought I would show you how I'm giving this big chest a makeover. I'll show you in a minute. It was one of the items I picked up. If you've seen my bedroom makeover, my linen storage cupboard, I picked it up from the same person I got that from. She basically gave it to me for nothing, really. And yeah, I thought I'd give it a bit of a makeover today and put it in my living room to use as a coffee table. So this is the chest here. It's a nice big sturdy one. Pretty ugly looking at the moment. It's got a heap of storage in there, which will be perfect for storing throw pillows and throw rugs and things like that that we're not using. So I thought I'd give it a bit of a makeover and use that as our coffee table in our living room. I've just got a couple of drop sheets on our furniture at the moment, just while I'm doing sanding and dusting and stuff like that. So what I plan to do with this one is basically just paint it in some white chalk paint, like pretty much what I do with all my furniture, and put a few little black accents on it, and hopefully it'll turn out pretty good. I also show you, I've been pretty busy, even though I haven't been on YouTube as much, but I have been pretty busy. I've given these side tables another bit of a makeover. I don't know if you remember that they used to be like a dark gray and black color. We painted them in some white chalk paint again and just added a bit of black accent. And same with this one over here. I'm just going to keep all my furniture pretty white, I think, just to keep it nice and light and airy. And also, this is a new addition. This you may have seen in a thrift store haul. They were actually two small, like little shelving units. One had about three shelves and then the other one had four. And I actually pulled them all apart and made one tall unit out of it. So that's probably about a bit taller than me, that unit now. And again, I've just given it a really rough coat of chalk paint. And I just really love the way it actually looks in this corner here. I did have a small little Kmart shelving unit here before, but it wasn't as like specifically for the corner. So, and I just felt like it wasn't tall enough as well for this space. I'm just really happy with the way it's turned out. And I just love the way it looks in the corner there. And again, I didn't film it. I don't know. Honestly, I just couldn't be bothered. I just wanted to get all this shit done so quick and just out the way because it's been bugging me for so long. And there wasn't really much to it. I basically unscrewed both the little units, screwed them back on so that it's one tall unit, and just gave it like the roughest coat of white chalk paint that you can do. Like basically just scratched it on there. And yeah, I'm just really happy with the outcome. So the house is coming along. Excuse the mess, I'm still in a big mess.
And look, I need to apologize as well. I did a big Easter haul, and I said in that Easter haul that yes, I was going to decorate for Easter, but honestly, I'm not going to get there this year. I tried my best. I just didn't have the heart for it because I've just got so much else going on all at once. So I really do apologize. I'm not going to get to Easter this year. I thought I would even just decorate a tiered tray just to show you guys, but I can't do it. I just can't do it this year. Once all this furniture crap is finished and out the way, and you know, I'll have so much more time and so much less stress in my head, I'll definitely be doing it. So I just want to get all this stuff done so that the house is finished and yeah, I can start enjoying it.
And so, I mean, like I said, excuse the mess on the end here. I'm still redoing stuff, but I've given our dining table a bit of a makeover as well. The dining chairs haven't been done yet. They're still disgusting and a mess, but I repainted all the bottom of the dining table. So in white chalk paint. And what I've basically done to the top is just sanded most of the stain off. I was never completely happy with the stain to start with. I just felt it was way too dark, and it actually was applied so dark that you couldn't see the wood grain anymore. And I just was not really 100% happy with it. and I just sanded it back, intending to put another stain on it, a little bit more of a lighter stain. But to be honest, once I sanded it back to this stage, I'm just really loving the way this looks at the moment. So I'm just going to leave it like this for now until I get sick of it, and then I can change it up again. I just really love it. It's just so rustic and just really, yeah. See, I did have my Easter stuff out ready to go, but I just can't. So the dining table is pretty much done. And after I finish this chest here, I'm going to start on these dining chairs because they're pretty horrid. So I've really jabbered on so much again, as always. Let's get started with this makeover. Because the stain from the chest was actually pretty strong, and it was still sort of showing through. And I mean, I can still see it showing through on certain areas, but I don't mind the way it looks at the moment. So we'll let this dry and then we'll start to decorate. Okay, so next I've bought some hardware off AliExpress. So I've got here a couple of, what do we call these? Hinged brackets, I guess they're called. These are only going to be used for decoration, so they're not going to be like used to actually open and shut the lid. I've got a couple of brackets that are going to go on the top. I've got a couple of handles here. They actually came in a big packet, I think of about, well, not a big packet, there's four, I think, that came in. So I've got two handles that are going to go on either side. And then I've got a couple of these decorative corner brackets that we're going to put on the sides of the chest as well. And we're just going to drill them on now. And everything on, and like I said, these are just for decoration. They're not actually like a working hinge or anything like that. So now we're just going to go around and distress it and then give it a good coat of some finishing wax, and we're done. So I'm just using some 100 grit paint. Or just beeswax, actually, is what I've got at the moment. I've just given it a good rub with the beeswax all over, just to help protect it a little bit, since it is going to be used as our coffee table. And yeah, I'm really, really happy with the way it's turned out. It's pretty much exactly what I pictured. So yeah, and it was super easy. And you know, excuse my shambles of a living room at the moment, just while I've got everything covered, while I'm painting and dusting and sanding and all that sort of stuff. So yeah, once I set it up, I'll do a little bit of a room tour and everything. So that's it from all sides. We've got, that's the back. And then inside, I didn't paint anything inside. I just left it as is. I'm just going to fix that little hinge there, same as that one. I hope you enjoyed that video, guys. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Thanks for watching.